I research primarily due to the, I would say, curiosity of really understanding the molecular mechanisms of disease. That perhaps is my primary passion, is really the curiosity in terms of pursuing mechanisms of disease. But also, I would say, in terms of potentially impacting the lives of cancer patients by understanding the molecular mechanisms of diverse cancer types. So I got into biomedical research. I think it actually began in high school with my, I would say, passionate and inspiring high school teacher of biology. And just through his enthusiasm for biology and biological mechanisms, that really got me hooked into potentially investigating disease mechanisms. And then upon my undergraduate years, where I actually was investigating disease mechanisms, and I spent a lot of time not only in the classroom, but also in the research labs during the year, as well as in the summers and so forth, really understanding different human diseases, and in this particular case, really understanding inflammation, I would say that that really hooked me into pursuing a career in biomedical research. You really have to be passionate about the research that you pursue, and you really have to be able to get up in the morning and want to rush off to the lab. I think you really have to have that type of desire in order to pursue this area of biomedical research, as well as, I think, the passion to train the next generation, I would say, of translational scientists and basic scientists as well. So you have to have that spirit as well, that you're willing to mentor others. One important aspect would be to have a strong foundation in terms of the basic basic sciences of cellular as well as molecular biology, and really be intent on really understanding those mechanisms during your classwork, and not to sort of take that for granted. I think that's very important in order to really be able to succeed in the biomedical research arena. I think in moving forward in terms of biomedical research, this is certainly the era of big data and analytics of on a multidimensional level. So I think really developing expertise in both bioinformatics and computational medicine, I think, will be important for sort of the next generation. The discoveries that have emanated from my lab have really been a team effort of individuals in different schools, different departments. Oftentimes, the individuals in the lab have different expertise in bioinformatics, computational medicine, as well as in molecular cellular biology, as well as in the more biomedical translational sciences. So it's really, I would say, sort of a confluence of distinct disciplines that come together that I would say that the University of Michigan is quite unique in. The award, I think, is very exciting, especially seeing the various luminaries who have received this previously, and it's an award given to cancer research in general. And it really just highlights work perhaps that will have an impact moving forward in terms of cancer diagnosis as well as treatment. So I was certainly very honored that I was chosen by the Royal Swedish Academy for this award.